digress a little bit. We use water in all its forms, ice, steam inhalations, or hot water. You can use a steam inhalation if you have a sinus problem, or even if you have a headache. There are some potions that we have to use when we are using hot water. Now, these are the things that we use hydrotherapy for: arthritis, osteoarthritis, and rheumatoid arthritis, muscle and joint problems, depression, sleep disorders to relieve stress, headaches or pain anywhere in the body, and I'll tell you later how we do that. We have other musculoskeletal problems, like a frozen shoulder, often caused by arthritis, ankle, sprained ankle, pain in the groin, and for ladies who might have pelvic inflammatory disease, we can also use hydrotherapy. We can use it following knee surgery or hip surgery, and in cases of fibromyalgia, where your whole body aches and you have very painful pressure points. You can also use hydrotherapy for neurological conditions such as MS, multiple sclerosis, Parkinson's disease, and in cancer. That is the whole subject on its own. For cancer treatment, you give what's called a fever bath, where the temperature of the water is very hot, at least about 105, but you have to have someone watching you, because you check the blood pressure before and after, and during treatment, you drink water. And fever treatments for cancer is about 3 times a week, or about a week or two. Next slide. Now, let's look at the effects of hot and cold. If you put your hand in hot water or you're having a bath, your capillaries dilate and blood flow is increased. Hot soothes the internal organs and has a calming effect on the body. Cold water, on the other hand, is tonic and it tones up the body. What happens when you get cold? You get goosebumps. Hot and cold release pain, reduces swelling, and gives you a feeling of relaxation and well-being. But there are some cautions. You would not use hot water on an acute injury, if there's an open wound, or if there's inflammation or sores. You would also have to use caution with frail elderly people and with very young children. You wouldn't use hydrotherapy on someone who has a paralyzed limb where there's no sensation at all. Next slide, please. Now, how it works. I think I alluded to that earlier. The hot water increases your circulation, your arteries dilate, and the blood flows better, the lymph also flows. We have nerve impulses in our skin, and the treatment affects the nerves, which also affects anything in your body, stimulates the immune system. Using hot and cold contrast showers stimulates what are called the natural T killer cells, which fight infection. Hot and cold influences the production of hormones, eases pain and swelling, reduces inflammation, and takes toxins out of the body. And that's also the case with drinking your water on a daily basis. Once toxins are removed from your body, your blood is now more efficient at taking up the nutrients from your food. Advantages. Well, it's relatively cheap, very, very cost effective. You just turn your tap on, hot or cold, you drink your water, unless of course you want to buy bottled water. That's a different subject. Increases your metabolism, which gets rid of the toxins, increases the flow of urine. After hydrotherapy, you feel relaxed. Even after a nice shower or mornings, tumor lines. Now, drugs lack this effect and may even produce the reverse. Now, yesterday I went to church at the tent, and it was very hot. And as a result, I became dehydrated. Although I took my water with me, I eased back on the water for obvious reasons. Now, if you have a headache, what do you do? Pardon? Paracetamol. Well, the drug companies and the advertisers of these drugs want us to believe that you can take ibuprofen, Panadol, Tylenol, Tylenol, Paracetamol, whatever, and your headache is going to go, just like that. But it's only a band-aid. It treats the problem temporarily. In the long run, it's best to use a method that you know will work, and then you don't get any side effects from the drugs. Next one, please. Oh, by the way, the pill didn't cause a headache, so taking the pill is not a long-term cure for headache. Now, your equipment. Very simple. For hot and cold treatment, and we're dealing today with a headache, you would have a bowl of hot tap water, and you can check the temperature either with your elbow or your fingers. You want it to be comfortably hot, but not tepid. And you need extra water in a kettle or a jug that you can pour into the water. Because at some stage you want to make the water hotter. You need towels, you need a towel on the floor, and you need towels to dry after. You need slippers and socks. The reason for the slippers and socks is that after the treatment, you must not put your feet on a cold surface. Now, for cold, you also need a bowl of cold water with ice cubes and extra ice cubes. The temperature will be 51 to 56 degrees or colder. You need an ice pack. And you also need a washcloth that you can dip in the water and drink around your neck. So you're going to sit comfortably, have your stuff in front of you, and alternate between hot and cold. So you're going to put your feet in the hot water for 5 minutes or so, and you take it out and you dunk it in the cold bowl with the ice. Yes, with the ice, for 30 seconds, you can count 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, etc. You are going to have a reaction. You may shiver, you think, oh no, I can't do this. So after 30 seconds, you do that, you put your foot in the hot water a second time, add in perhaps a little bit more hot water. Another 5 seconds, in the other bowl, more ice, in the cold water, 30 seconds, and you do this for 3 consecutive times. And you finish with cold, at the end of which you are going to dry your feet thoroughly and put on your socks and your slippers, and you go to bed. At the same time that you're working on your feet, you have the cold flannel draped around your neck, or you can have an ice pack on the top of your head. You can also alternate, half hot on the shoulders and cold on the feet. How it works is that when you use hot, it dilates. The short cold causes the dilatation to stop and then increase. Okay, so we need to practice the 8 laws of health, which I'm sure you all know. We need to have a good diet. We need to exercise on a daily basis. Drink 8 to 10 glasses of water per day. 12 is even better